morning, everybody. This is breakfast time again. Hallelujah. Happy new week and happy stress-free week in Jesus Christ's name. We have passed the middle of February. Is God not faithful? The hand of God has steadied us, has preserved us, and is still keeping us in safety. And I pray for you as I pray for myself. This month of February, nothing broken, nothing missing, no limitation in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. We are still on our topic, pray with us season. Praise the Lord. And as I said before, it's a series and this is part two. As I said before, it's a program that we had Women on the Mission by the special grace of God in our group once in a month. Next weekend, this weekend we'll be having it on the 23rd. If Jesus tarry, we'll be having it live and direct again in Pamplona, our second meeting for the year. Praise the Lord. And in that meeting, God brought his choicest daughter, Pastor Juliet, and she ministered powerfully. Well, gave us the word for the now. You know, she taught us about the winning prayers, which I think I shared part of it last week. From also part of the from it last week, I took some part from there. Then she also told us the purpose of prayer. And then I wrote something because I also had my part that I was going to talk about, but I didn't have the chance to say something. I said prayer is to speak to God either privately or in religious ceremony in order to express love, admiration, or thanks, or in order to ask for something. So many a times, many of us pray without ceasing when we are in trouble. We pray without ceasing when we are in trouble. But prayer is not only pray to ask. You can pray to appreciate God. You can pray to admire him. You can pray to honor him. You can pray to give him thanks for that which he has done for you and even for that which is yet to do in advance. You can pray to ask for something. But if you now begin to make it as if that the only time God hears your voice is when you are in need, then we have to have everything and make a change. Hallelujah. God is not a magician. Sometimes try to say thank you. And you can pray and say, Father, you are worthy. This morning, Lord, I just lift up my voice unto you, the King of glory, the Lord of honor, the sustainer of my life, the one that made me who I am, the breath in my nostril, the meaning to my life, the one that took me to bed in peace, the one that woke me up in safety, the one that steadied me, the one that is God all by himself, the one that makes a way for me when there seems to be no way. This morning, I lift up my voice to say, you are worthy. You are great. You are marvelous. You are excellent. Lord, beside you, there is no other. Lord, I worship you. I say, car be a seat to you, Lord. Car be a seat to you, Lord. The sustainer of mankind. The one that sits upon the circle of the earth. The whole habitants are like grasshopper. He that laid the foundation of the earth, I beg your pardon, upon the waters. You are just, what are you doing? You are appreciating him. You are just giving him thanks. Praise Master Jesus. And we said, I also wrote here, this is my own note. I wrote here, I said, praying without ceasing is the attitude of God's consciousness and God's surrender that we carry with us all the time. That attitude of God's consciousness and God's surrender that we carry all the time with us. Praise Master Jesus. Praise the Lord. So you can pray without ceasing to appreciate him, to admire him, to express your love, to give him thanks, and to ask God. Let God not only hear you because you are in need. Let him hear you telling him thank you. Let him, Lord, you are great. Lord, you are great. Demons tremble at your presence, Lord. Let him hear you. Hallelujah. And today, our teacher told us, he said, the purpose of praying without ceasing. He said, one of the purposes is to keep us dependent on our God, on our relationship with God. The purpose of praying without ceasing, one is to keep us dependent on our relationship with God. You are constantly in touch with God. And two, he said, for us to break through in every areas of our life, what are you seeking for? What is the breakthrough you are looking for? Or come of favor? What is that thing you are looking for? He said, for us to break through, we have to constantly pray with our season. Yes, he gave us an illustration about a man, Elijah. You remember the Bible make us to understand, I think in the book of First Kings, by the spirit of God, in First Kings, when we look at 16, 17, he's this man that prayed and shut the heaven. Elijah prayed fire down. Elijah did wonders with prayers. So it was time for him now. He shut the heaven for 3 years, 6 months. It was time for him now to open the heaven. He had to pray again and again. Praise the Lord. And look at what he said in verse, in 1 Kings 18, 43. This is what he says here. He said, and he said to his servant, go up now, look towards the sea. And he went up and looked at the sea. There is nothing. And he said, go again seven times. He said, for us to break through in every areas of our life, we must constantly pray. She made us to understand. Elijah understood that there are times answers don't come immediately. So you need to continually pray until answers come. Let's read that a little. He said in verse 44, I will read to 46. He said, and it came to pass at the seven times that he said, behold, there ariseth a little cloud out of the sea, like a man's hand. And he said, go up, say unto Ahab, prepare thy chariot, and get thee down, that the rain stop thee not. And it came to pass in the meanwhile that the heavens was black with cloud and wind, and there was a great rain. And Ahab rode and went to Jezreel. And the hand of the Lord was on Elijah, and he girded up his loins and ran before Ahab to the entrance of Jezreel. Praise Master Jesus. So pray with our season. There are times that that situation you are confronting need you to persist in the place of prayer. Need you to continue to pray. No wonder I remember the Bible say, you see, up till now, ye have not asked. Not that you have, he said, ye have not asked. Meaning, the way you were asking was different. Say, you have not asked, you've not prayed. Praise the Lord. And the man of God continually, imagine, he prayed seven times. This is a man that prayed to shut the heaven. The Bible did not tell us how many times he prayed before the heaven shut. But he had to pray seven times now for the heavens to be opened. He said, it empowered us. Elijah was powerful because he was a man of course. He was a man consistent in the place of prayer. Even the Bible makes reference to it in the book of James chapter 5. When we look at 17, James 5, the Bible told us, you see, Elias was a man subject to like passion as we are. And he prayed earnestly that it might not rain. And it rained not on the earth by the space of 3 years and 6 months. 18. And he prayed again, and the heaven gave rain, and the earth brought forth her fruit. Praise the Lord. There is power in prayer. A man that prays without ceasing is a man that you don't dare. Is a man that you don't battle with, because he wrestles in the realm of the spirit. He understands that the battles of life are not just only physical fight. The battle, the victory, first of all, you must be won in the realm of the spirit before you come manifesting physically. So he understood this. And I tell you, child of God, if you understand that for you to live every day victorious, then you must be a man of prayer. You must be a woman of prayer. You must persist in the place of prayer. Jesus, the Bible made us to understand, after he rose up from the water in Jordan, the Spirit of the Lord, after descending upon him, he said he was led by the Spirit into the wilderness. What? To pray and fast for 40 days. To pray and fast for 40 days. And when he came out from the wilderness, he never stopped praying. Each time he withdraw and pray. Each time he withdraw and pray. That was why he was able to tell us in Luke 18, he said, we should pray. We should pray and don't quit. My sisters, my brothers, let's develop this habit of prayers. If you don't pray, you will become a pre. So if you don't pray, you will become a pre. A man that prays is a man that the devil does not go to his direction. It's a no-go area. You know, it's a no-go area because he's always at alert. He's not a man that sleeps in the realm of the spirit. Before the thing comes, God has already opened it. Because why? He communicates in the realm of the spirit. He goes things out in the realm of the spirit. You know, he cancel and reissue things in the realm of the spirit. So I trust God for your life that as we go through this week, let's think about it. Let's go back to our place of prayer. Let's go back to our place of prayers. In far back in the 80s, in the 70s, in the 90s, we can tell that the Christians we have then are they prayer warriors? They are just Christians, but they pray more. But today we want people to pray for us. Pastor, pray for you. You are looking for somebody to pray for you. You have a mouth. Pray by yourself. Open your mouth and pray. Not that it's wrong for somebody to pray, but don't just make it a habit that people pray for you. You pray with your mouth. Pray with your mouth. God is everywhere. God wants to hear you. Pray. And I pray God Almighty will give ears to your supplication. Even as we make a new decision to go back to the place of prayer, God will honor your cry in Jesus' name. Have a stress-free week. And by the special grace of God, this weekend, on the 23rd of February, if Jesus tarry, we are having our meeting here in Pamplona. Please be our guest. Be our guest. It's taking place in Aswain, the usual place. Hallelujah. Be our guest and God bless you real good in Jesus' name. Have a stress-free week. Remember, 1 Thessalonians 5:17. Pray with us. God bless you.